Hello friends, welcome back to my new lecture. Today, in this lecture, we are going to derive general heat conduction equation for Cartesian coordinate. For this particular derivation, let's consider a figure given here. Let's consider a broad figure first of all. This is the wall in which I have shown a three dimension. First dimension is x dimension, so it is an x axis, it is a y axis, and z axis will be on a back side. So I have to derive an equation of general heat conduction equation for this particular wall. For deriving this, I am going to consider a small element. This is a small element on which I am going to derive an equation, and then from that I am going to derive the equation for complete wall. For the small element, the width in x direction is dx, in y direction the width is dy, and in z direction the dimension is dz. So for this particular small element, dimension is dx, dy, dz. These are the three sides of this element, and for this I am going to derive an equation. Now this element, if you get expand and draw the figure, I will see this particular figure. So this figure is nothing but this element, which has a dimension dx, dy and dz. For this figure, let us see the dimension shown here. This is the cube which we have considered. In that x direction the dimension is dx, in y direction dimension is dy, in z direction dimension dz. So this is the element which we have taken from wall, which has a dimension dx, dy and dz. For this particular element, the heat interaction is there from three sides. Heat entering in x direction is qx, so this is x direction, horizontal direction. Heat entering in x direction is qx. Heat exit from x direction is qx plus dx. So x plus dx is suffix here, and here suffix is x. So entering heat is qx, exit heat is qx plus dx. Heat entering in y direction, which I have shown by red color, heat entering in y direction is qy, whereas heat exit in y direction is qy plus dy. Okay. Similarly, in z direction, heat entering is qz, this is the heat entering in z direction, qz, and heat leaving in z direction is qz plus dz. So these are a heat interaction which is happening with this particular element in three direction. So in x direction, y direction and z direction heat is entering. At the same time, in x direction, in y direction and z direction heat is leaving. So I had to derive general heat conduction equation for this element. For this, first of all I am going to consider the energy balance equation. So let's write an energy balance equation first of all. So the energy balance equation for this, I can write like this one. So this I am writing according to energy balance equation. According to energy balance equation, net heat input plus heat generated in element, this is second. So summation of these two is nothing but change in internal energy. So what we have written, this equation we have written for this particular element. So for this element, if I consider energy balance equation, net heat input is the heat input in all three directions plus heat generated in the system. If I make summation of net heat input and heat generated in the system, that will give you change in internal energy of the system. That's what energy balance equation we have written. Let's consider this is the equation number 1. Now what I am going to consider, this equation I am going to divide into three parts. What are the three parts? The first part is this one. So this is part number 1. Part number 1 is net heat input into the element. Part number 2 is this one. This is part 2, which is heat generated in the element. And next is this one, part 3. So this equation number 1 I have divided into 3 element as part number 1, 2 and. Now what I am going to do is I am going to derive an equation for all these three part, and I am going to put one by one into equation number 1. So means first of all I am going to derive equation for part number 1, Then I am going to derive equation for part number 2. And finally, I am going to derive equation for part number 3. And all these 3 equations I am going to put into equation number 1 to get the final equation. Now, let's derive one by one. Let's consider a part number 1 first of all. So, I am going to consider a part number 1 first, and which shows that the net heat input. Now, what I am going to write is net heat input in all 3 directions. Let's consider net heat input in all 3 directions. So, net heat input in all direction is nothing but, I can write heat input in x direction. So, I have 3 direction. So, this is heat input in x direction. Next is heat input in y direction. And third is the heat input in z direction. So, heat input in z direction. So, I consider 3 direction, and the net heat input in x, y, z is nothing but total heat interaction to this one. So, this one I can write net heat input in x direction. Let's refer this particular figure. In this figure, if I consider x direction entry is qx, exit is qx plus dx. So, if I take a difference between these two, input is qx, output is qx plus dx. If I take a difference between these two, that will be net heat input in x direction. In y direction, qy is entering, exit is qy plus dy. If I take difference between these two, that will become net. Net means what? The difference between these two. In z direction, qz is input and qz plus dz is output. So, difference between these two will be the net heat input in z direction. Okay. This has came from principle. I will show you a simple example. If I take this as element, in this element, if 100 joule amount of energy is coming in and exit is, let's consider 20 joule. So, 100 is coming and exit is 20. So, what will be net heat input? In this case, net heat input will be 100 minus 20. That is entry minus exit. And we'll get 80. So, this is called as net heat input. Similarly, if qx is input and exit is qx plus dx, then what will be net? Net will be qx minus qx plus dx. So, this is net heat input in x direction. Similarly, I can write for y and I can write for z direction. Okay. So, by this principle, let's write first of all for x direction. So, for x direction, as I told you, that is qx minus qx plus dx, that is net heat input in x direction, plus net heat input in y direction, that is qy minus qy plus dy, plus in z direction, similarly, I can write qz minus qz plus dz. That's the equation we have got. And let's consider this is the equation number 2. So, we have got an equation number 2. Now, next task, what we have to do is, we have to find out an equation for net heat input in x direction, net heat input in y direction, net heat input in z direction, and then that equation we have to put in equation number 2 to get the final equation. So, now, consider x direction. So, first of all, I am going to derive an equation for only x direction. So, for x direction, net heat input in x direction, which we have an equation as qx minus qx plus dx. That is the net heat input in x direction. Now, what I am going to do is, I am going to expand this term according to Taylor series. That is from the mathematics. From the knowledge of mathematics, you will be knowing what is Taylor series. So, by the Taylor series, I am going to expand this one. So, let's expand this. So, what I am going to do is, according to Taylor series, this is from knowledge of mathematics that you might be studied in M3. Okay. So, qx plus dx, that can be expanded by the Taylor series as qx plus d of dx, qx
dx one factor. So what we have done is this, I am going to expand. If I am knowing qx, I can find out qx plus dx by using Taylor series, which says that qx plus dx is nothing but qx plus d of dx qx into dx upon 1 factorial plus the next term. This is the first term we have written. Next term is the d square upon dx square of a qx into dx upon 2 factorial. The third term I can write as d cube by dx cube qx dx 3 factorial. Next there will be 4 factorial, 5 factorial, like that we can go on expanding. Okay, so this we have written by Taylor series, as we are knowing that the dx is very small element, as I showed in the initial figure. In this particular figure, the dx is very small element. As dx is small element, so dx square will be again very very small, and again we are taking 2 factorial, which is divide, so that will be also very small. So as this term becomes very small, here onward I am going to neglect all other term. So I am going to neglect this one. So now what I will get, qx plus dx according to Taylor series, it will give you qx plus d of dx qx into dx, 1 factorial is 1. Okay, now this we have got qx plus dx, this I am going to put in which equation? This particular equation, that net heat input in x direction is qx minus qx plus dx. So here I am going to write, let's consider this equation number 3. So in the equation number 3, I am going to put qx plus dx equation. So let's put this, put in equation number 3. So when I put this into equation number 3, what we will get is that net heat input in x direction is equal to qx is as it is minus qx plus dx, I have to put it. So minus qx plus dx will become this value I am going to put now. So it will become qx plus dabba of dabba x qx dx. This we have done it, we have put in equation number 2. Simplify this particular equation. How to simplify in this particular equation? Here what I am going to do is qx, this minus sign goes inside, so it will become qx minus d of dx qx dx. That's what equation we have got it. So now this qx qx will get cancelled. What is remaining is minus d of dx qx dx. This is what equation we have got, net heat input in x direction. Now we know in this particular, this is what, net heat input in x direction. This qx value, this qx value I am going to write according to Fourier law of conduction. So according to Fourier law, according to Fourier law, what Fourier law says, q is equal to minus ka dt by dx. So here is partial derivative, so it will be d dabba t by dabba x. That's the Fourier law. So if I am writing this for direction x, so this will become qx, this will become kx, this will become ax. If I consider this for x direction, so it has become qx, that I have to write here, qx is equal to minus kx ax dabba t by dabba x. What is kx? Kx is thermal conductivity in x direction. Ax is perpendicular area in x direction. Dt by dx is change in temperature with respect to x. So this I am going to put here. So what will get an equation now? The equation will become minus dabba by dabba x into bracket this term means what? Minus kx ax dabba t by dabba x into dx. This is what we have got, an equation for what? Heat input, net heat input in x direction. Now I am going to simplify this. What is the ax that we have to see? Ax is what? Area perpendicular to x direction. What is the area perpendicular to x direction? This is the x direction. If I consider this is x direction, then what is perpendicular area? Perpendicular area is this one. The perpendicular area is this perpendicular area. So what is dimension of this? This perpendicular area. Dimension of this perpendicular area is what? Dx and dy. This will give you this particular area. Okay. So rather than Ax, now Ax, what I am going to write is
dy into dz or dz into dy. This I am going to put. Okay. So in this particular equation, I am going to replace ax by using dy dz. So let's write this particular equation. Now net heat input in x direction. Net heat input in x direction will become dabba by dabba x into bracket minus kx. Ax I am going to write dy dz dabba t by dabba x dx. You have to understood here dx is complete derivative and dabba is what? Dabba is what? Partial derivative. Dx some of the time it is also called as exact derivative and dabba is called as partial derivative. Okay. So again simplify this particular equation. How to simplify this? This I will take inside. So minus minus will become a plus. So plus I will write kx. This dx comes on inside. So it will become a dx dy dz. What I have done? This dx I have put here and this I have taken inside. So it has become a kx dx dy dz. Dx dy dz into this and this, it will become a square, dabba square t by dabba x square. This is what we have got, net heat input in x direction. So we have got this in x direction, that's the equation number. If I check, if I go back and if I check the equation, this is the equation number 4. So we have got equation for equation number 4. Now what I have to do, similarly I can write here, similarly for y and z direction we can get this equation number 4 for y and z direction. So what will get y and z direction? Similarly, net heat input for y direction, for y direction it will become what? Ky, same equation, I am going to repeat this particular equation, ky dx dy dz. Instead of this, it will become a dabba square t dabba y square. So what is the change here? Instead of x I have written y, instead of x square I have written y square. That's the equation number 5. Similarly, net heat input for z direction. So what will be equation for z direction? Equation for z direction will become a kz dx dy dz dabba square t dabba z square. So we have got net heat input for three direction, that is x direction is equation number 4, this is x direction, this is y direction, this is z direction. Now total heat input will be summation of all this. Total heat input will be summation of all this. So in the initial equation we have written, referring to this particular equation, in this particular equation net heat input, that is the part 1. Part 1 is what? Heat input in x direction, y direction, z direction. So from that we have written equation number 2. In equation number 2 I am going to put value of this, this and this by using equation number 4, 5, 6. So I will put equation number 4, 5, 6 in equation number 2. Okay, so put equation number 4, 5, 6 in equation 2. So what will get an equation now? Net heat input in all direction, in all direction I will get as equation number 4. What says equation number 4? Kx dx dy dz dabba square t dabba x square, that's in x direction, plus in y direction what it says equation number 5, ky dx dy dz into dabba square t dabba y square, that's the in y direction, plus in z direction. In z direction is this one. So kz dx dy dz dabba square t dabba z square. So we are written for 3. Now simplifying this particular equation, how to simplify? Assuming for the isotropic material, isotropic material is what? Material which has the same property in all direction. So I am assuming that it's isotropic material, so property will be in same in all three direction. So what I am going to assume is thermal conductivity in x direction, y direction, z direction is same. So it will become k is equal to kx is equal to ky is equal to kz. So I consider kx, ky, kz is same. So from this I can take common k, at the same time dx, dy, dz. So what will be next equation we will get it. The next equation is like this. In this particular equation,
net heat input in all direction,
is equal to, I am going to take common k and dx, dy, dz. So k dx, dy, dz into bracket. What it remains? It remains this term, daba square t, daba x square plus daba square t, daba y square plus daba square t, daba z square. So we have taken common this, and this will be equation number 7. This will be equation number 7, and this will be equation for our part number 1. So part number 1 gets completed here. Okay, so this is part number 1. Now I have to go for part number 2. What is the part number 2? If you refer this particular figure, part number 2 is heat generated in the element. Okay, so let's consider now part number 2.
Now I will consider that the part 2. So what gives the part number 2? Part number 2 is heat generated in the element. Heat generated in element is nothing but, this heat generated, I can write one thing, that heat generated per unit volume into volume of element.
That's the equation for net heat generated. Why? Because this is the heat generated per unit volume, that we denote by small qg. If it is per unit volume, so its unit will be what? Kilowatt per meter cube. And if I multiply by meter cube, the meter cube get cancelled, it will get a kilowatt. So we want a net heat input. So that's why we are going to write this one. So net heat input is generally denoted by qg, which is having unit as heat transfer per unit volume into volume. Now what will be volume of element? If you refer this particular figure, in this figure what will be volume? Volume is multiplication of all three dimensions, dx, dy, dz. So if I multiply dx, dy and dz, that will be volume of this particular element. So I'll write dx, dy, dz, and this is what, equation number 8, and we have got part number 2 equation. So this is equation for part number 2. Okay, so part number 2 is quite easier one. Now let's go for part number 3. What is our part number 3? If you go for basic equation once again, here in the basic equation, change in internal energy. Part number 3 is what? Change in internal energy. So let's consider
change in internal energy, and this change in internal energy, I am going to use a simple equation which says mcp delta t.
So this I am going to write mcp delta t, delta t change in temperature, but here it's unsteady state, so I am going to write change in temperature with respect to time. The dou t by dou t I have written it. Okay, so this is change in internal energy, part number 3. In this case I can write that mass is nothing but density into volume. This is standard equation. How we can write? Because mass may have unit as kg. So this I am writing a unit. Density is kg per meter cube. What is volume? Volume is meter cube. So meter cube get cancelled and we will get kg. So mass can be replaced as rho v. So this equation, what I am going to write is rho, density into volume into Cp, other term as it is dou t by dou t. What is the volume that you are knowing? What is the volume? Just now we have written here that volume of element is what? Dx, dy, dz. Same thing I am going to write here. So rho into dx, dy, dz, and then dou t by dou t. This will give you equation number 9. and equation for part number 3. So we have got equation for all 3 parts now. Here we have written part number 1, which is nothing but net heat input, and net heat input we have got this equation. Part number 2, which is heat generated in the element, we have got this equation. And part number 3, which is change in internal energy, we have got this particular as a equation. Now all 3 part we have got. Now all 3 part I have to put in equation number 1, which is our basic equation, that is part 1, part 2, part 3. So in equation number 1, I am going to put equation number 7, 8 and equation number 9. So now let's put this, all these 3 part I am going to put in equation number 1. So I'll write here as put equation number 7, 8 and 9 in equation number 1. So equation number 7 is part number 1, equation number 8 is part number 2, equation number 9 is part number 3. These 3 I am going to put in equation number 1. So what will get it? The part number 1, what is part number 1 that we have already derived? That k dx dy dz, that you can refer, just now we have proved, dabba square t dabba x square plus dabba square t dabba y square plus dabba square t dabba z square, that's the equation number 7 and part number 1 plus. So this is part number 1. What is part number 2? Part number 2 is heat generated, and which is nothing but qg dx dy and dz, that is the part number 2, is equal to part number 3. What says part number 3? Part number 3 is dx, already we have derived equation part part number 1, 2, 3, dx dy dz dabba ty dabba t. So these 3 parts we have got it, and we have put into equation number. Now we have to simplify this. From all 3 bracket number 1, 2 and 3, what I am going to take? I am going to take common as a k dx dy dz. So if I take common as k dx dy dz, what will be inside a bracket? From this, if I take k dx dy dz, so what is remaining? Remaining is this term. So I'll write as a dabba square t dabba x square plus dabba square t dabba y square plus dabba square t dabba z square. This is what first term we have got. Plus from this, if I take common as a k dx dy dz, dx dy dz is already present there, but k is not present there. So as k we have taken common outside, so on denominator k will be added and numerator qg is added. From this, what we have taken common outside is k dx dy dz. Okay, so this is from right side. From left side I will write as it is rho dx dy dz dou ty dou t. This is what equation. Now this dx dy dz and dx dy dz can be cancelled, and this k cp is remaining here, rho cp, this is cp. Okay, so this k I am going to take on this side. So what will be equation? Now the equation will become dabba square t dabba x square plus dabba square t dabba y square plus dabba square t dabba z square plus qg by k. This k I am going to take on this side, so it will become rho cp by k into dou t by dou t. That's the equation we have got it. Now I am going to introduce new term, that's what called as thermal diffusivity. In the heat transfer there is one term, that's what called a thermal diffusivity, which is denoted by alpha, and that is nothing but k by rho cp. So in the above equation, in this particular equation, if I want to put an alpha, so how we can put alpha? This can be replaced by alpha, and that's reciprocal, so I will write 1 upon alpha. So what next equation we have got? Dabba square t dabba x square plus dabba square t dabba y square plus dabba square t dabba z square plus qg by k is equal to 1 upon alpha dou t by dou t. So this is what equation we have got, and this equation itself is called as a general heat conduction equation for Cartesian coordinate. This is a required equation which we have to derive.